A very good afternoon to all of you present here. We welcome you back for the third lecture of Drishtikon, a one-day colloquium on disability and Hindi cinema. Upholding the motto, labels are for jars and not for people, Center for Disability Research and Training Kirorimal College, which is the first of its kind across the University of Delhi, was set up with the objective to create and promote inclusive teaching and learning atmosphere on campus, to generate and spread awareness in society about matters pertaining to disability, as well as to enhance the understanding of the phenomena in its multifaceted manifestations. Today, we have with us Ms. Mansi Grover, a PhD research scholar at the Department of English, Jamia Millia Islamia University, and Ms. Priyam Sinha, a PhD research scholar at the National University of Singapore, English Department. I'm very glad and obliged to have this opportunity and chance to introduce this session. I now hand over the mic to the chair of this session, Professor Rudrashish Chakraborty. Please, sir.
Thank you, and a hearty welcome to all in the post-lunch session of the day-long colloquium. You know, it's indeed a proud moment for me to introduce Mansi Grover. A proud moment because I just realized, and Mansi told me around 10 minutes ago, that I happened to teach her in the master's classes in the University of Delhi, in the arts faculty. And it's indeed a small world that, you know, we end up, you know, facing, crossing each other in different parts. Mansi Grover is a PhD research scholar at the Department of English, Jamia Millia Islamia. She's looking at the representation of women with disabilities in Hindi cinema since 1970. Her upcoming publications are Actor as a Time Traveler, Politics of Performing Age on Stage, Problematizing Sight, Interrogating the Representation of Women with Blindness in a Select Few Hindi Films, To Stare or Not to Stare, and Stare, To Stare or Not to Stare, An Effective Study of Disability, and Mayuri's Disability as Manhusiyat, Problematizing the Classical in Nache Mayuri. She also practices theatre and has been working with a Delhi-based theatre group since 2017. Her areas of interest include cultural studies, disability studies, feminist studies, age studies, film studies, performing arts, and post-colonial studies. Mansi, the stage is all yours, you know, for your presentation.
Of disabled people around you. You would enter a metro, you know, there are seats reserved for differently abled people, you know, is again a very problematic term. So you see, you know, disabled people around you. Now, what is the first thing that you do? And I'm going to the very fundamental of it, very fundamental of it. If we come across something which is different from us, so look at it as a different body. If we look at it as a different body, what do? You give it a stare. And I'm not going into negative and positive of it. Let us understand, we are not going into negative and positive of it. We need to understand what our body does. What our body does in the presence of something which is different. And why is it different? Why is it different? Can anyone answer this? Why do we feel it's different? It's not like us. It's not like us. So what are we doing with that mere stare? We have created a distance of us and them. You see, that is the fundamental of it. And through films. We are looking at films. It's very important. And I feel as a film scholar, as a person who's studying disability, and I'm still learning. Each day I read a new article and I'm like, wow, matlab, this is amazing. ये तो क्या ही बात लिख दी इन्होंने, मतलब मैंने कभी सोचा भी नहीं था. सो यू नो यू नीड टू रीड इट लाइक दैट बिकॉज एवरी डे इज अ यू वुड कम अक्रॉस अ न्यू आर्टिकल. इट्स सच एन इवॉल्विंग फील्ड. इट्स सच एन इवॉल्विंग फील्ड. फिल्म से हमें अच्छा बुरा रिप्रेजेंटेशन वो तो हम देखते ही हैं. दैट्स ऑल्सो वेरी सिंपलिस्टिक वे ऑफ लुकिंग एट फिल्म. वी ऑल्सो नीड टू गो इन टू डीपर डिटेल्स ऑफ हु इज क्रिएटिंग अ फिल्म. फिल्म में ऐसा क्या दिखाया जा रहा है और क्या उसका हमारे पे कुछ इम्पैक्ट है. आपके रेफरेंस में व्हाट वाज द फिल्म दैट यू हैड रिसेंटली वॉच्ड दैट हैड अ डिसेबल्ड कैरेक्टर इन इट. कोई भी रीसेंट फिल्म बताइए. मैं पूरी रिसर्च करके आई हूँ. सर्वे 17, 18, 19 ईयर्स के बच्चे क्या देखते होंगे इस टाइम. सो यू हैव टू टेल मी. और मैंने भी आपकी वजह से वो सब देखा है. सो टेल मी. अरे लो ना नाम लो. आई नो ऑल द बजरंगी भाईजान भी देखी है सबने. देखी है ना सबने बजरंगी भाईजान. सबने देखी है यहाँ पे. क्या होता है बजरंगी भाईजान में. Okay, she has a speech impairment. क्या करती है उसकी फैमिली. Why do they go to India? They have to visit what place? They are not coming for a trip. They are on a pilgrimage. Right? They go to Nizamuddin Dargah. The mother and the daughter, they go to Nizamuddin Dargah. So first point that you get to see is we still have a religious model in India. We do believe that, you know, disability is caused by sins of past due to bad karma, and this could be quote unquote rectified, quote unquote fixed, quote unquote cured if we pray to God, whoever God we pray to, and this could be rectified. तो पूरी फिल्म में आप क्या देखते हैं. The girl is lost और उसको बचाने कौन आता है. Our very own सलमान खान. The entire film goes by the girl does not speak. Last में क्या करते हैं. Heightened moment कब आता है फिल्म का. Towards the climax. When she says Jai Shri Ram and she says the word Mama. Right? सबने देखी है ये. क्यों ऐसा किया. क्यों ऐसा किया.
I think it's the Hindi film way of, you know, having a satisfying climax and also just solving the problem.
So what does satisfy us? क्या सेटिस्फाई करता है हमको. अ हैप्पी एंडिंग. और हैप्पी एंडिंग में क्या होता है.
थिंग्स आर फिक्स्ड.
फिक्स्ड. सो दिस इज द वर्ड फिक्स्ड. फिक्सिंग द डिसेबिलिटी बिकॉज वी आर फिक्सेटेड विद एबिलिटी. एवरीथिंग दैट इज अराउंड अस. अभी भी आप देखेंगे आपके कॉलेज ने तो बहुत इवॉल्व कर लिया है. But if you look at the infrastructures outside your college, you would see they are not disabled friendly. Metro एक ऐसा space है जिसको disabled friendly बना दिया गया है. बहुत अच्छा काम किया हुआ है उस level पे तो. But otherwise you would see a lot of houses would not have lifts. हमारे घरों में lift नहीं होती है क्योंकि हम लोग इतने आगे तक नहीं सोचते कि हम लोग को aging होगी. And aging is also a part of acquiring a disability. So we do not realize that we need to create structures which are inclusive of everyone. इसलिए आप buildings में भी देखेंगे, films में भी ऐसा ही देखेंगे कि एक certain section of society को तो खुश कर दिया, What about somebody who actually has a speech impairment? What about somebody who has dyslexia but can't paint well? कौन सी फिल्म है ये? तारे जमीन पर. एंड क्या हुआ? ही वन द कॉम्पिटिशन बिकॉज दे हैड टू शो इट लाइक दैट.
They have to substitute his disability with something.
Overcoming.
Right.
It's an overcoming narrative. Overcoming disability narrative. Because that suits the able-bodied imaginary. Right? Able-bodied imaginary क्या कहता है? सब कुछ अपने जैसा कर देंगे हम. एक जैसा कर देंगे हम. Homogenize कर देते हैं सब कुछ. और डिसेबिलिटी स्टडीज क्या कहता है? यू नीड टू लुक एट द डाइवर्स बॉडीज. यू नीड टू लुक एट डिफरेंट बॉडीज. हम लोग वी टेक आवर बॉडीज फॉर ग्रांटेड बट आवर बॉडीज आर एट अ वेरी वल्नरेबल पोजिशन. समबडी हु हैज एन एक्सीडेंट लूजेज अ लेग, उसकी जो आइडेंटिटी है वो एबल्ड से डिसेबल्ड की हो जाती है. समबडी हु इज यूजिंग अ प्रोस्थेटिक लिम, यू सी हाउ यू आर ट्रेवर्सिंग द बाउंड्री ऑफ एबल्ड टू डिसेबल्ड. हाउ डू यू नेगोशिएट विद दैट? अगर हम सारी फिल्म्स में यही दिखाएंगे कि लड़की, आई एम टॉकिंग सिंस माय फोकस ऑफ एरिया इज अ वुमन, आई एम यू नो लुकिंग एट वुमेन विद डिसेबिलिटीज, अगर हम लड़की को एंड में क्योर कर दें, उसको फिक्स कर दें, तो वो हम वापस से उसको नॉर्मेट बना देंगे. ये नॉर्मेट वर्ड किसने दिया? आप पढ़ेंगे अपने लेक्चर्स में, अपनी क्लासेस में, रोजमेरी गार्लैंड, शी टॉक्स अबाउट नॉर्मेट. ठीक है, और एक आपको वर्ड दे देती हूँ, शायद आपने सुना हो, द बेल कर्व. सुना है द बेल कर्व? बेल क्या हुआ? व्हाट इज द शेप ऑफ अ बेल? राइट, द बेल कर्व आप पढ़ेंगे लेनर्ड डेविस. ये दो तीन नाम आप याद रखें वेन एवर यू नो यू आर रीडिंग डिसेबिलिटी स्टडीज, बिकॉज दीज आर द वेरी फाइन राइटर्स हु हैव रिटन अबाउट दीज वर्क्स विच आर द फंडामेंटल ऑफ डिसेबिलिटी स्टडीज. तो ये तो आपको पढ़ना बहुत ही जरूरी है जब भी आप डिसेबिलिटी स्टडीज की बात करें. बेल कर्व क्या है? आई एम गोइंग इन टू अ लिटिल टेक्निकल बट आई विल कम बैक टू फिल्म इन अ वाइल. बेल कर्व है कि जो भी हम समझते हैं दैट वी आर द आइडियल, वी आर द एवरेज, मेजॉरिटी हमको ऐसा लगता है, वो है इस बेल के अंदर. और जो डेवियंट्स, डिसेबल्ड, क्रिपल्ड, ब्लाइंड, डिसफिगर्ड, डिसफॉर्म्ड, वो सारे कहां आ जाते हैं? ऑन द एंड्स. और जो हमें लगता है हमारे जैसे हैं, मेजॉरिटी, उनको हमने बेल के अंदर डाल दिया. सो दिस इज अ फॉर्मेशन ऑफ अ बेल कर्व. अब अगर आप फिल्म्स देखें तो उन सब में भी आपको यही दिखेगा. यू गो बैक, फर्स्ट यू क्रिएट अ डिसेबिलिटी नैरेटिव बट टुवर्ड्स द एंड यू वुड सी द कैरेक्टर गेटिंग क्योर. एंड दिस इज अ फॉर्मूला टू गिव यू हैप्पी एंडिंग्स, क्योंकि हमें ऐसा लगता है कि डिसेबिलिटी मीन्स ट्रेजिडी, डिसेबिलिटी मीन्स सम सॉर्ट ऑफ डेफिसिट. और अगर हमारी लाइफ में डिसेबिलिटी हुई या किसी और की लाइफ में डिसेबिलिटी है तो हमें ऐसा लगता है, हमें माने एबल्ड बॉडीड को ऐसा लगता है कि वो तो इंसान दुख में है. देयरफोर द एबल्ड बॉडीड इमेजिनरी इज क्रिएटिंग फिल्म्स आल्सो अराउंड दैट. कोई भी फिल्म आप ले लीजिए, फना देखी आप लोगों ने, काजोल एंड आमिर खान, क्या होता है उस फिल्म में? काजोल इज ब्लाइंड. द फर्स्ट सीन इटसेल्फ, अगर आपने ध्यान से देखे फिल्म, द फर्स्ट सीन इटसेल्फ टॉक्स अबाउट the parents discussing that the girl needs to make a choice. Actually, the girl doesn't have to make a choice. The parents are making a choice for her, whether she can go to Delhi or not, whether she can travel alone or not. And the next thing they are discussing is she would meet her Shehzada in Delhi. तो एक ये एक आपके लिए एक आर्किटाइप बना दिया गया है. ऐसी एक फिल्म बनेगी, हीरोइन होएगी, हीरो आएगा उसको बचाने, उसको क्योर कर देगा एंड देयर इज अ हैप्पी एंड. इफ यू लुक एट फिल्म्स, 1958 की एक फिल्म है अगर आप देखें, जेलर. आई कुडंट गेट द क्लिप ऑफ दैट फिल्म, इट्स देयर ऑन यूट्यूब, इफ एनीवन इज इंटरेस्टेड तो आप देख सकते हैं. Again, there is a narrative. The girl gets an eye implant or uska cure ho jata hai. And that is the happy ending. 1960s, 70s, 80s, 90s. Come to 2000s, you are looking at a film like Fana. Usme bhi same hi cheez aapko milegi. Kahin kahin aapko ruptures dikhenge. Now let us look at those ruptures also. It's very important to look at the ruptures also. You create a film which is about a person who is blind. Actually the film is not about that person. The film is about the hero, jo ki usko bachayega. But you also need to look at the ruptures where the woman gets agency. Wo chote chote moments analyze karne bahut zaruri hai. To main bhi aapko ek clip dikhati hu. First we'll talk about हर एक फिल्म में आपको दिखेगा देयर इज अ ड्रीम सीक्वेंस. ड्रीम सीक्वेंस में क्या हो रहा है, द बॉय इज इमेजिनिंग द गर्ल एज एबल बॉडीड दिख रही है एंड दे आर डांसिंग. इट्स अ ड्रीम सीक्वेंस जो कि एंड में पूरा हो जाता है. द ड्रीम इज फुलफिल्ड टुवर्ड्स द एंड एंड हु इज द सेवियर, हु इज द क्योरर, द मेल हीरो. राइट, अभी आप चला दीजिए इसमें से द ड्रीम सीक्वेंस. नीचे देख रहे हैं आप संगीत इसके साथ वाला, ये पहले में आइए, इससे एक पहला, हाँ ये चला दीजिए. प्लीज लुक एट दिस ड्रीम सीक्वेंस. This is a very interesting dream sequence where you would see the guy is imagining something but the girl has a different imaginary. Please look at it.
कौन आया लगे मन भाया, जिंदगी के पास मुझे कौन ले आया, ये कौन आया लगे मन भाया, जिंदगी के पास मुझे कौन ले आया, हो रब्बा कोई तो बताए, हो रब्बा कोई तो बताए, चैन होता है क्या जैसा मेरा खो गया, सबका खोता है क्या जैसा मेरा खो गया, सबका खोता है क्या, ओ रब्बा।
Imagining Madhuri Dixit as able body. But Madhuri Dixit, when she was imagining herself in the same dream sequence, she was imagining herself as blind. So one could also see that this idea of cure is also an able-bodied idea. This getting a cure, getting an eye, you know, retinal transplant or, you know, a cornea transplant is also something which is created by the able-bodied normal imaginary. To go back again to the hegemony of normalcy. Hegemony to samajhte hain yahan pe sab? Yes. To go back again to that ideal where a heterosexual couple, an able-bodied couple are happily living together, right? Aisa aapko bahut sari films mein dikhega, bahut sari films mein. Now when we talk about a disabled woman aur jab hi hum ek able-bodied woman ki baat kare, do you feel the concerns are different? When we talk about feminism, you know, you must have read feminist theories. You talk about concerns of women. So are we also taking into consideration the disabled women? This is actually something that posed a problem. And therefore, there's a lot of dissatisfaction in disability scholars when they look at feminist studies, because they excluded the disabled women from it. The color, the women of color, they were included very late in the feminist discourse. It was around 1980s. 1980s mein aap, 1989 mein aap sunte hain word intersectionality. जब इंटरसेक्शनैलिटी आ रहे तभी भी वहां पे डिसेबल्ड वुमेन की बात नहीं हुई. तो व्हाट अबाउट डिसेबल्ड वुमेन? द आइडिया ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंस फॉर एन एबल्ड बॉडीड वुमन इज डिफरेंट फ्रॉम व्हाट इट इज फॉर अ डिसेबल्ड वुमन. द आइडिया ऑफ चॉइस, द आइडिया ऑफ वुमनहुड, अगर आप एक डिसेबल्ड वुमन से पूछेंगे, जो कि आपको फिल्म से भी देखने को मिलेगा, व्हाट इज देयर सेंस ऑफ सिक्योरिटी? कभी बात कीजिएगा किसी से तो आपको पता लगेगा देयर आइडिया ऑफ सिक्योरिटी इज वेरी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम व्हाट इट इज फॉर समबडी हु इज एन एबल बॉडीड पर्सन, एन एबल बॉडीड वुमन. तो देयर इज अ ह्यूज लूप होल इन द फेमिनिस्ट स्टडीज ऑल्सो. And there, you know, disability scholars are writing about how you can create, how you can bridge the gap. How you can bridge the gap by talking about lived experiences. What are these lived experiences? Kabhi word suna aapne ye? Phrase suna hai, lived experiences. Kya hai lived experiences? अभी हमने जो देखा, मान लीजिए वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द सेम गर्ल, उसका लिव्ड एक्सपीरियंस क्या हो सकता है?
जितना भी अभी जो उन्होंने एक्सपीरियंस करा
है. ओके, राइट. तो जब हम इस तरीके की बहुत सारी डिटेलिंग करते हैं, सो वी आल्सो गेट टू नो अबाउट देयर कंसर्न्स. और जो कि अभी अभी आपने बहुत सारे क्वेश्चंस किए थे पिछले लेक्चर में, हाउ दैट कैन बी ब्रिज्ड, हाउ यू नो डायरेक्टर्स, हाउ कैन द राइटर्स यू नो ब्रिज इट, हाउ कैन दे ब्रिंग इन डिसेबल्ड राइटर्स, डिसेबल्ड एक्टर्स इन द मेकिंग ऑफ अ फिल्म. डिसेबिलिटी स्टडीज का मोटो है नथिंग विदाउट, नथिंग अबाउट अस विदाउट अस. तो जब हम इंक्लूसिविटी की बात करते हैं, सो यू नीड टू इंक्लूड पीपल फ्रॉम अ पर्टिकुलर कम्युनिटी व्हेन यू आर क्रिएटिंग अ वर्क अबाउट देम. अभी रिसेंटली एक फिल्म आई थी ओटीटी पे, आपने देखी होगी, जलसा. क्या खासियत है उस फिल्म की अपार्ट फ्रॉम द फीमेल लीड्स विद्या बालन एंड शेफाली शाह? उस फिल्म में ऐसा एक क्या एक दिखा आपको? देखी किसी ने जलसा? Very recent film, just 2-3 weeks back. बहुत पढ़ाई करते हो आप लोग, OTT बिल्कुल भी नहीं देखते. ऐसा तो हो ही नहीं सकता. So they have casted a kid with cerebral palsy in it.
Right. If there is a disabled woman, what is the perception around it? Goffman ने एक किताब लिखी है स्टिग्मा. When you would read about disability, you would come across it. Stigma. He talks about how a different deviant body, the moment you see it, it is discredited. You would associate certain attributes to that body. This is evil, this is negative, this is asexual, this is something that is done to almost every disabled character, right? Ek bahut hi bahut, the film got a lot of credits also for it. Black dekhi, black mein kya hota hai? Black dekhi kisi ne yahan pe? Yes. Can you just give me a very short summary of Black?
Ma'am, it's a story of a teacher and a student and how he found an alternate way to communicate to the student.
Okay. Uske सिस्टर जो है उसमें शी इज एन एबल बॉडीड पर्सन, शी इज नॉट ब्लाइंड, शी इज नॉट डेफ, शी इज एन एबल बॉडीड पर्सन. कभी भी आप एक फिल्म देखेंगे, यू वुड ऑलवेज सी देयर इज ऑलवेज अ कॉन्ट्रास्ट क्रिएटेड. एक एबल बॉडीड वुमन दिखाएंगे, एक एबल बॉडीड मैन दिखाएंगे, साथ में एक कॉन्ट्रास्ट भी जरूर होगा. एज एन डिसेबल्ड और एबल्ड का एक कॉन्ट्रास्ट जरूर आपको देखने को मिलेगा. अभी आप सर ने एक क्लिप दिखाया था आपको साजन फिल्म का, राइट? उसके अंदर सज्जन दत्त इज समबडी हु हैज अ फिजिकल डिसेबिलिटी इन लेग. उसका कॉन्ट्रास्ट कौन थे? सलमान खान, राइट? लैक जैसी फिल्म में रानी मुखर्जी इज प्लेइंग अ डेफ ब्लाइंड गर्ल और उनका कॉन्ट्रास्ट उनकी सिस्टर ही है, घर पे ही है. सो यू कुड सी व्हाट कुड यू नो घर पे क्या चलता होगा बिटवीन टू सिस्टर्स, राइट? एक सीन मैंने आपके लिए ढूंढा है, एक बार मुझे दिखाइएगा. इसमें ब्लैक में मिशेल सेकंड्स जी.
अब क्या हुआ?
वो नीचे नहीं आना चाहती. तुम्हारे इन-लॉज के सामने आने में शी इज फीलिंग ऑकवर्ड. शी थिंक्स शी स्पॉइल्ड द इवनिंग.
फिर यहाँ तक आने का नाटक क्यों किया?
स्टॉप इट सेरा. एक तो मिस्टर सहाय की तबीयत ठीक नहीं रहती, उसकी वजह से वो परेशान है. प्लीज, इट रियली हर्ट्स मी टू सी द टू ऑफ यू फाइट लाइक दिस. नाउ यू गेट हर रेडी एंड यू ब्रिंग हर डाउन. मुझे बहुत सारा काम है.
मिशेल, मेरी एक रिक्वेस्ट है तुमसे. आज तक तुमने जो भी किया वो स्पेशल था, बट टुडे इज अ वेरी स्पेशल डे फॉर मी. आई एम इन लव और मेरी एंगेजमेंट तुमसे पहले हो रही है. आई नो दिस कुड अपसेट यू. शायद तुम्हारी जिंदगी में ये शाम कभी नहीं आएगी एंड यू मे बी फीलिंग दैट यू विल नेवर फॉल इन लव. आई होप यू विल, आई रियली डू. बट अंटिल देन प्लीज डोंट स्पॉइल माय इवनिंग, ओके?
लाइक दिस इज एक्चुअली समथिंग दैट अ डिसेबल्ड वुमन कैन इंटरनलाइज आल्सो एंड दे हैव इंटरनलाइज्ड अ लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स अबाउट देयर सेल्फ एस्टीम, अबाउट शेम, अबाउट गिल्ट, अबाउट नॉट फॉलिंग इन लव, अबाउट them being undesirable for the other person. So there's a lot of, you know, negative notions that you internalize. Or I'm amazed when, you know, films like these are made. And the film Black, something that I know I have watched, you know, when I was a kid, the way it would have impacted me. And I had no encounter of disability before that. Like, I couldn't think of any other person around me who was disabled apart from my grandmother who was aging. So what impact this would have on somebody who was watching a film at the age of 15 or 10? Say for example, if a blind woman is watching this film, that she may never find love. And this narrative has been repeated in the film. It's repeated in the film. There is also a sequence before that where, you know, the mother is telling Amitabh Bachchan, the teacher, that you also need to teach her that, you know, she may never find love. So since the start, since the age of 8, she has internalized this, that she may never find love. And there's another scene that I have picked where, you know, she asks her teacher to kiss her. Because, and you would feel very distressed while watching a scene like that. I don't know, let's watch. This is the first. Yeah. I just pause it. And this is after the sister, Sara, has got married and she shares a kiss on the lips with her husband where, you know, now she is, Michelle is feeling that, you know, she may never find somebody like that. and nobody would ever want to kiss her because she is deaf, because she is blind. Okay, please play it. So she has come to her teacher's room.
What are you doing here?
Wanted to talk. Do you love me? Shayad tumhe shaharik pyar kabhi na mile. Lekin
I have worked with deaf actors and I've met people who are deaf, and the film in black, when you watch it, it becomes more about somebody who is blind. जब ये आप फिल्म देख रहे हैं, she is also deaf. But the film, on a very, if you just look at a film, it becomes more about somebody who is blind. Now, why that could be possible? Now, the film is based on Helen Keller, right? Helen Keller, if you read about Helen Keller, she herself has been a very controversial figure. She was a deaf-blind woman, and this is something that, I'm not quoting it, she has said it in her own autobiography, that she feels that, you know, she advocated blindness more. Uske bhi apne reasons hai. जब भी आप हिस्ट्री पे जाएंगे तो उसके अपने और रीजंस मिलेंगे आपको. शी एडवोकेटेड फॉर ब्लाइंडनेस, राइट? वो सब आपको इस फिल्म में भी नजर आएगा. द वे यू नो द डायलॉग्स आर रिटन, द वे आर डायरेक्शन इज डन, ब्लैक एंड व्हाइट. व्हाट इज ब्लैक एंड व्हाट इज व्हाइट फॉर समबडी हु इज ब्लाइंड. इस तरीके के आपको बाइनरीज फिल्म में जरूर मिलेंगे. Something that struck me while I was watching this film, and I have an entire chapter on this, the film never talks about deaf friendships. If you talk to deaf people, if you look at their lives, they have very strong friendships. They have very strong friendships, and I feel Michelle as a character has been denied that friendship at all. The only character, you know, who knew sign language in a way, you know, her teacher knew it, was her teacher. And in the start of the film, you would see Amitabh Bachchan says that, you know, he has other deaf students also. But you would never see Michelle meeting other deaf people. Where are these other deaf people? Is she the only person disabled around them? And therefore, again, you know, you would see films falling back to creating it as an individual's problem. Whereas, it's the social infrastructure, it's the cultural myths that we have created which are problematic. The individual is not the problem, but the way film has been presented, you would feel that, you know, where are these other people? And she had that kind of resource there who could have brought in other deaf people, other blind people to meet her, but you would not see any other character who is blind and deaf in the film, which is very surprising. And it creates as a lone character, and you know, then you would see a scene like that. Then you would see a scene like that where she feels undesirable, where because she has not met any other person in her life who could see, you know, that there is some sort of similarity. They could have created some sort of, you know, similarity. And mind you, when we talk about disability studies, feeling a community is very important. A person who is disabled, when you come across another person who is disabled, you feel there is a sense of community. There is a sense of shared oppression. But that has been denied to maximum, you know, characters that you will see in the films. Gulzar in 1970s was able to create a film like Koshish. He was able to create a film like Koshish, which, and I have a clip for you, remarkably made, I feel, at times, but it has its own problem. Wait. Opening credits, yes.
Thank you.
mainstream audience, right? And that is something that Gulzar has managed to do with this film. This film, numerous people have spoken about it, and I feel and this film is able to capture certain moments which I feel are so important for a deaf woman. Now, for a deaf woman, see, when somebody is deaf, you know, they do not consider themselves as disabled. Deafness has a very different, the people who are deaf, they see it as a linguistic difference. They see it as a different way of life. And they are not seeing it as in terms of binaries, of, you know, somebody who can speak and somebody who can hear and, you know, somebody who can. So they do not see it as some sort of deficit. And at times, you know, Gulzar has able to capture that in 1972. You need to remember it's 1972 when he is making a film like that. So there's a very small moment in the film where Jaya Bachchan, she is the husband and wife, Jaya Bachchan and Sanjeev Kumar, they are sitting and it's their wedding night, and they talk about how Jaya Bachchan's mother has asked her not to conceive, not to have a baby, because that would increase her chances of creating another deaf person in the world. Yes, very right. Now, when you talk about eugenics, you read about Helen Keller, right? Because the figure of Helen Keller becomes problematic when you look at how at times she was also a promoter of eugenics, which she later regretted also. And she has written that, but there were moments when she had propagated this idea of not allowing deaf people to marry each other, as they might create more deaf people in the world. So basically, deaf culture is also like a subculture to the oralist culture. Because if somebody is not talking to us, it becomes a problem for us. It's not a problem for the deaf person. It's a problem for us. So, it's called the oddest world. Oddest world wants to create, do not want to create more deaf people. Therefore, believing in eugenics. Right? Now, I want to share that, clip with you, where, you know, she is delivering the baby. Wait. The delivery scene. Yes.
कैसी हो बेटी? हाँ, ठीक ठाक तो हो? भगवान की बहुत बहुत दया है। और ये हैं हमारे दो ताजी। अच्छा, कितना सुंदर है मेरा ललना, बहुत ही प्यारा है। हाँ, इसके कान भी तुम्हारे जैसे हैं। हंसने लगा अब तो तू है अभी से जो 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 हाँ बड़ा सुंदर है सच्ची मैं तो बताना ही भूल गई हाँ सुन सकता है बोल भी सकता है
If you see the film here, the film who is born would be called a coda, child of deaf adults. Now when you look at the positionality of a coda, again it's a very, very complex situation. Some writers have called it border crossing. Some writers would call it contact zones, because they are basically a contact zone between hearing and non-hearing. So their position is very, very complex. Now, one of the films that was made about a coda was Khamoshi. Right? And Khamoshi starts with, it stars Manisha Koirala, Salman Khan, Nana Patekar, and Seema Biswas. Now, Nana Patekar and Seema Biswas, they are a couple who have a daughter, and they also have a son, but he dies in an accident. Now, when you watch the film Khamoshi, it starts with Manisha Koirala reciting her story. Similar scenes you would see in Black. Black starts with a sequence with Michelle writing, typing her story. Now my question is it her story? Is it actually her story? When you are looking at a film which is made by a male director, an able-bodied crew, would you call it her story? Somebody who is a coda? Somebody who is a blind woman? You can ponder over this and look at this clip. This is it. Opening scene, Black opening scene, fourth number.
I'm Michelle McNally. शिमला में बसे एक एंग्लो इंडियन परिवार की बड़ी बेटी। ये कहानी है मेरी और मेरी टीचर की, बची कुची मिट्टी से बनाए गए उन दो इंसानों की, जिन्होंने अपनी तकदीर से जंग लड़ी और नामुमकिन को मुमकिन कर दिखाया। मेरी इस कहानी की दुनिया ही कुछ अलग है, जहां पहुंचते ही आवाज दम तोड़ देती है और रोशनी आंखें मूंद लेती है। ये मेरी दुनिया है जहां कुछ दिखाई नहीं देता, जहां कुछ सुनाई नहीं देता। अगर एक ही शब्द में बयां करूं तो मेरी इस कहानी का नाम है ब्लैक।
What is the impossible dream? Manisha Koirala, who is a coda, wants to hear her parents call out her name. Right? And towards the end of the film, you would see the parents struggling, fighting, and they take out Annie out of their mouth. Annie is her name. And they take out any of their mouth. And you would see that they are literally crying their eyes out. They are depressed about the fact that they cannot call Annie, they cannot call out her name. Similar things you would see in the recent Oscar-winning film, Coda. And there is a critique written about it by Leonard Davis, somebody who is a coda himself, talking about how these films, they are not able to celebrate the deafness, how these films are not able to celebrate these diverse bodies and these diverse ways of living. Now there is one scene that I wish to show here, and it's a beautiful scene. It's a scene from the film Koshish, Body Calligraphy. Wait, I'll just talk about it first. Now here, you know, you would see every disabled person would create a system which is very different from an able-bodied person's system, right? How you operate in your home, how you create your things, whether you follow, you know, what kind of sizes of doors are there in your house, how you have created the bell, the doorbell, and what are the different ways they would try to create their own system. Now, Koshish as a film was able to celebrate that in a very these very small moments that Gulzar created, whereas Khamoshi showed a very pitiful state of the parents. They are literally crying, hoping, you know, Annie never leaves them. But if you see a film like Koshish, and if you see this particular scene, and I was so impressed by watching it, that, you know, this kind of system could have been created. Please play it. Wait, let me just tell the story, okay? So now, before this, what has happened is, they have lost one of their child, okay, he drowned in a rain, and they could not listen to his cries. So, you know, they are full of guilt. They are full of guilt. They don't know how to go about the other kid now that they have another kid now. So what they have done is they have a friend at their home. So he is blind. He is not deaf. So now they have created a system where he is helping them out. So this is how a deaf way is created. Maybe this is not real, maybe this is just a fiction, a work of fiction, because this is a work of fiction. But it's a way of looking at things. It's a way of looking at things. Like there's another film, Nache Mayuri. Have you heard of this film? Must have heard in my intro only. So this is a film, and this is also a biopic, where Sudha Chandran, the actress, has played herself in the film. And she is a Bharatanatyam dancer. She loses one of her legs in an accident. And she has played herself in the film. When we talk about performing disability, and when we talk about whether one can cast disabled actors in a film, then we do have films like this. We do have a film like Nache Mayuri. And I feel, by watching the film, you would be able to look at things from a very different perspective. Now, when somebody starts using an assistive device, when somebody starts using a prosthetic limb, how would your body change? There's a writer, Donna Haraway, she would call it a cyborg. It's a mix of organic and inorganic. Right? You create, and she goes on to say that, you know, ultimately all of us would be cyborgs. Right? Now, when you look at Nache Mayuri, Mayuri is a dancer. And she is passionate about dancing. For her, when she loses her leg, it was not about walking. It was about dancing. And the film not just shows you, you know, Mayuri, you know, finally on stage, giving a performance, like a usual film you would see, which somebody called an inspiration porn. Right? In this film, you would also see, and I think that is the highlight of this film. That is the highlight of this film, where you would see a prosthetic limb getting made in a workshop. How is that limb made? How is it aligned on the leg?
and whether, you know, is it just a one day work or does it take time for it to adapt? What are the various struggles that one goes through while fixing a prosthetic limb on the body? Can you just... So I have taken on a few scenes from Nache Mayuri. There is a workshop scene.
Right. धान से आओ, इनके पैर का नाप लो, सब बताइए। ये पैर दिखाइए।
Can you just open this? Yes, alignment scene.
नहीं मिलेगी, लेकिन दुनिया को मिल सकती है। अगर मयूरी दोबारा मयूरी बनकर वापस आ जाए तो मुझे जरा भी ताज्जुब नहीं होगा। बसंती की चिट्ठी से पता चला है कि वो इलाज के लिए जयपुर गई है। वहाँ के डॉक्टर उसे नया पैर देने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं।
नया पैर? इम्पॉसिबल। खड़ी हो जाइए। बेटी, इन बांस को पकड़कर वहां तक चलो, चलो। कोई बात नहीं, शुरू में थोड़ा दर्द होगा। कमन, कोशिश करो बेटी। चलो चलो।
Talking about pain, right? You could see it on her face that she is, you know, in a lot of distress with the fixing of this new leg on her. Now, if you look at Mayuri's character, it is played by Sudha Chandran, who herself is a prosthetic limb user, and it is actually her story. Now, Toby Sivers talk about this concept of disability drag. What is a disability drag? Something that you saw when we were looking at Rani Mukherjee. There is an exaggeration. There is an excess in the way she is performing disability. The way she is made to walk, she is made to walk like a kid. Desexualizing her. Infantilizing her, which is also very, when you read about disabled people, they would tell you how, you know, they are treated as kids, how they are being protected by the family and treated as kids, and that you would see in the character of Rani Mukherjee also, the kind of clothes she is wearing, whereas her sister, who is younger to her, is not given such clothing, the way she carries herself. There is also a myth of beauty and perfection which is created. When you watch films like Black, who is desirable, who is not desirable, who is, you know, capable of loving someone. But when you watch films like Nache Mayuri, it dismantles body perfection. it dismantles what you would call as classical dance. If you read Natya Shastra, it talks about how it does not allow somebody with a physical disability to perform on stage. The dancer is not supposed to have any sort of body imperfection. But Mayuri is a figure that transcends, that disrupts the classical. She disrupts the body perfection, the image of a perfect body. And there is a next clip that I want to show you is of her performance. And please look at what is happening before her performance. Right? This is, yes, on the left. Mayuri alignment before performance. On the left. Yeah.
तेरी इस परीक्षा में भगवान तेरी सहायता करेंगे. Wish you all the best, Mayuri.
On the prosthetic limb, Alta, that you would put on your feet before a performance, they are putting that on the prosthetic limb also, making it a part of your body. And people who use any sort of prosthetics, they would talk about how, you know, it took them time to make it a part of their organic being. This inorganic, mechanical foot took some time for it to align itself on her organic body. And a film is able to show you all that. I mean, when I was watching this film, I was totally amazed that they are able to show you an amputated leg. Usually you would see I don't know how much time I have. There is also a scene from the film Man, which is a little longish scene, maybe we can leave it, where, you know, Manisha Koirala is lying on the bed and later she discovers that, you know, she has lost both her legs. And never again in the film they have shown her amputated foot. They could have used any effects. I mean, they would create anything. The film industry has that kind of, as sir was talking about, arsenal to create an image like that. But never again, you know, there is an image of, you know, an amputated foot. And she is time and again shown, you know, sitting with a shawl on her legs, but not an amputated foot. This is for the first time you would see something so visual. And, you know, you are amazed at how they have managed to, you know, align it. And, you know, it, you would not feel any sort of anxiety. You know, there is a writer who talks about the primal scene of anxiety. The writer's name is Ato Poesen. Primal scene of anxiety. Kya hai ye primal scene of anxiety? When there is an encounter between a disabled and a non-disabled. So non-disabled imaginary mein kya hota hai? Ek anxiety create hoti hai from that primal scene of encounter, right? So us tarike ki koi aapko anxiety nahi dikhegi. It is so fluid. The film is so fluid in the way it talks about the prosthetic limb. Now, when you talk about these diverse kind of bodies, it becomes so important to also look at sororal spaces. When we are looking at women, we also need to look at sororal spaces. What are these sororal spaces? Where women are sharing, women are having heart-to-heart conversations. A disabled woman with her mother, and I don't have that much time left, where I wanted to show you a few more clips, but she talks about where you know in Margarita, Lila is, you know, her mother is bathing her, and they are discussing that Lila has feelings for a boy. And there's another scene when they are sitting on the terrace and she tells her that, you know, she is bi, although that's a very comical scene also. But these kind of sororal spaces, if they are provided to women or not, where, you know, they are not talking about, they are basically having heart-to-heart conversations about what they feel. So these are called sororal spaces, and if you look at disabled women, these becomes all the more important. Because of the added marginalization, added stigma that, you know, these bodies would carry with themselves. So it's so important to look at these sororal spaces. A few films have managed to do that. One of them is Margarita with the Straw. You would also see a certain hint of it in Black. And there are more films also. And in this film also, Nachiya Mayuri, she has a very, you know, strong space that she shares with her grandmother and with her friend. So it's important to look at these moments also. Now, where I would like to end is something, again, it's a film, but I'm not going to show you any clip for that. I want you to watch it on your own, because I feel it's a brilliant film. The film is Ship of Theseus. You've not watched it? You've watched it. This plant. And one of the stories there is about retina transplant, the first story, cornea transplant. Now, the film, I will not reveal the end to you because I love the ending of the film. But that film raises a lot of questions for us. Is our body complete, whole, the same all the time? Or have we evolved? Have we evolved? Now, if you read biology, you would see our blood cells, they are, you know, they recreate themselves. Even our skin cells, they are dead skin on all of us. So new cells are made every second day in our body. So are we the same?
The Ship of Theseus paradox.
Yes, the Ship of Theseus paradox. So this idea of completeness, this idea of wholeness, this idea of living in nostalgia, oh, meri body to aisi thi. I used to do this, I used to do that. Our bodies are always evolving. And mind you, we are always on that juncture where we could traverse the boundary of abled and disabled any moment. With COVID, that has become all the more visual now. So many of us are going through anxiety issues. So many of us have, you know, mental health issues now. Depression. Maybe that disability is not visible, but it takes not a very great moment where you would transgress that boundary of abled and disabled. Why I'm making this point is because I want you all to understand that our bodies are always in a continuum. They would change. The early we accept that, we would be able to diminish the difference between us and them. So my first question when I started my lecture, my first question to you was, how many of you have come across disability in your life? So we all need to understand that we are living in, the bodies that we have are vulnerable. And anyone and anybody can traverse that boundary. So we are all always in a permanent state of temporary able-bodiedness. We are temporary on this abled-bodied tangent. Thank you.